we've chosen to build classrooms for girls in particular in Afghanistan because from 1996 to 2001, during the Taliban regime, girls weren't allowed to go to school. It was against the law. It was punishable by death.
Tell us the story. How did you attend school during the Taliban regime?
Well, the Taliban regime that was not allowed for girls to go to the school, and I just studied private courses. There was a lady, and teaching was a religious subject.
And so many of the teachers fled the country, schools were burned down, destroyed, and now, since 2001, they're flooding back into the schools. In fact, in 2001, at the end of the Taliban era, there was 100,000 students in school, all boys. Now there's 9 million. So you can imagine that nobody could keep up with building the infrastructure for all of these schools. So what has happened is that, you know, girls are sitting on the ground, the classrooms are intense, and that's okay. It's great that they're learning, but we really would like to provide them with better structures for them to study in, and so we've chosen to build 100 classrooms. In May 2010, we opened Niswan 2 Girls School, which has about 2,000 girls, and we were able to provide them with 6 classrooms and refurbish about 12. And the community showed extreme support. The governor of the province even came out for the grand opening ceremony. Now in 2011, our goal is to open up 16 classrooms, 4 at one school and 12 at another. And that'll impact about 1,300 students. And then next year, our goal is to open up Charmgarh Khana High School. This school is located on the site of an old armory, and they have 2,028 girls and 1,700 boys. And currently, they have one building. It's a bullet-riddled classroom for grade 6, and a playground that's a tank, and 30 tents, and that is where they study. So our goal is to build 35 classrooms at this school and to provide them with adequate bathrooms. You know, one classroom out of 100 may not seem like a lot, but for $6,000, which is the amount for one classroom, over 100 girls can be educated in a year. And if you count together all of the 100 classrooms that we will be building, that's thousands of students over the next few years who will have improved conditions and a better life because of this.